Ready?
Welcome to Flite Test. I'm Josh. Recently, we got to meet up with an amazing flying couple from our Flite Test community. Shane and Heather McDowell have a passion for flying wing racing. They not only build them together, but they fly them together and travel all over the country racing wings. A very difficult task is making the wings durable enough to take an impact. These will oftentimes fly up to 100 miles an hour, and when it hits, you want to make sure it's durable enough to be able to survive. One way they do this is by applying laminating film. I've never been able to do this process very well, and it always comes out looking wrinkly and poor. Heather and Shane were kind enough to let me into their home and show me exactly how it's done. So Heather,
yes.
What is your wonderful husband doing?
He is spraying this wing with the Super 77 adhesive. And we do that before we laminate the wings. It just helps the laminate stick better. Yep, exactly.
Gotcha. And this Super 77, we've used that in the past for stencils, all sorts of stuff. It's really useful.
All sort of things.
So at one point, you could probably have three or four of these suckers hanging up, right?
At many points, we do.
How long are you going to let it dry?
We're going to let it dry for about 20, 30 minutes.
So good medium wet coat. All right, so the wing is now, the Super 77 is dry?
Yes.
All right, so what are you going to be doing now?
I'm going to pinstripe it now, and that's kind of my little trick to keep my edges really sharp. I pretty much just put pinstripe that we get from AutoZone over all the edges just so that they're nice and straight.
So does the Super 77 help that stick a little better
as
well?
Yes, it does. That's why we decided we used to try to do it before, and it just doesn't stick as well.
I still can't believe that you brush paint this.
Yeah.
That's amazing. And one of the ways you got your edges so hard is you actually lightly groove it with an X-Acto razor blade, don't you?
Yes. We tape it up, and then we actually run a really shallow slit, like a cut right next to it. And then the paint kind of tends to go down into that rather than kind of like a millimeter thick kind of thing. Yeah.
Now, you guys got something really cool going on here. Explain what's going on with this bottom piece of foam.
This is the wing bed that the wing was actually cut from, the EPP. Team Legit sends these with the wings.
Okay.
So we use them a lot. We use them, it's really good when you're laminating, keeps the shape. You don't end up flattening anything out when you're doing it.
You don't want to warp it, do you?
Right.
Here you've got something to work with, whereas if this wasn't here, and it's going to stick because of the 77.
Yeah.
If this wasn't here, well, first of all, the wing would be rocking when you were doing it, but you also don't have that area that you can go past the leading edge. So if you don't follow this leading edge, if you don't go all the way through it and complete it, then you'll get wrinkles across the leading
edge. Very good point.
Is there a roll at the limit?
Yes.
And you said this is 3 mil?
Yes.
Where do they get this laminate at?
It ships with the Team Legit kits. You can also buy it on the Team Legit website. I've seen it a couple other places.
All right, so all the laminate is spread out?
Mm-hmm. Get it nice and spread out. You don't want it to be wrinkled up anywhere. I usually start in the middle and kind of work my way out. And you want to start heating in the middle and work your way out from there, because if you start here and then you're over here, you're gonna end up with wrinkles in between.
Okay.
This is, from what I understand, it's a tile cutting tip.
Okay.
And so it's really just a bunch of burrs. It's not actually a cutting surface. But it really does well on EPP. It cuts real nice. And the thing is that if you do actually come in contact with it, it won't actually hurt you.
It's kind of nice because it doesn't even pull it really aggressively either.
No. I mean, I've turned this on and stuck my finger on it. I'm not going to do it because that's not a good idea for anybody to try. But
this will be the first time it does.
Yeah.
And
I'll share another flash gangster secret with you. When you use the Dremel tool, take a razor blade and cut the area that you want, the nice straight line. And then when you cut with this, it'll pull the foam away from it, leaving the razor edge. So you still get hot wire razor kind of edges.
You guys are doing like friction fit covers and everything. I was wondering how in the world are you doing that with a tile in it?
Yeah.
And that's how you do it.
Yep.
All right, so Heather, the top side is done?
Yes.
Now we're working on the bottom.
Now we're going to do the bottom.
All right, so you have it nested on the new piece.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so how are we going to make this work?
Okay, so after we do that, I always cut, and I already did this, I cut two slits right there, and then I fold this down, and we'll land that down.
That's nice. So you have a seamless leading edge then.
Yes.
And then you guys go over and double the leading edge up just to get a little bit thicker?
Mm-hmm.
Most of the time, yeah. When you're doing lam like this and you've got a paint edge on the other side, if the iron comes off the lamination and touches this, you'll get paint on the iron. So we keep a paper towel and alcohol there to clean it. But see what she's done is she's left like a quarter of an inch not heated up.
You don't want to touch that paint.
Yeah, she's staying away from the paint with the iron. And then when she does this, she'll go back over it and seal that whole thing up.
Beautiful.
The way this works, we fold this down, and then this works perfectly to cut this off, and it'll cover this little triangle at the end that we're missing.
Makes sense.
Yeah.
We feel really fortunate to get to spend time with Heather and Shane. Look for more episodes to come with this wonderful couple. And also, we want to sincerely thank you guys. Heather and Shane both fly wings from Team Legit. These are competition racing wings, and they really perform great. If you guys are new to the hobby and you want to try this out, both Heather and Shane got into the hobby through VersaWings. We have a newer version that's also a little bit more durable and a little faster called the Aero. If you guys want to see that, we'll have links down below. It's a very easy and affordable way to get into the hobby and also race some wings. Well, we have amazing people from the community coming out and sharing their knowledge and passion. It truly helps us move the hobby forward and also gives us knowledge that we simply don't have. So if you guys have any knowledge or anything you want to share, please leave it down in the comments below. And if Heather and Shane have inspired you, I'd strongly encourage you to go check out the channel. We're going to have some links listed below. And also, if you're going to Drone Nationals, you're going to get to see them personally. Make sure you subscribe, and we'll see you next time.